Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam borei peri hagafen. Now take yourself off mute and let the
Oh, I love this. Oh my God, that's the perfect blessing. So welcome to Rabbi Python's Holy Cocktail.
Woo! Woo!
Tonight, we will have four cocktails. To get to four cocktails, you have to count to four. You may not stop at three, you most certainly not stop at two, and you certainly cannot get to five. That is beyond ridiculous. We will have four, only four, that is, four cocktails tonight. And I'm so excited for an incredible mixologist who I think all made new drinks for this, which is impressive. We will have cocktails and mocktails. They all have a Purim theme, at least a Purim title. Some people did some real research, which I give you credit because I just brought the bottle of bourbon into my closet. So, you know, cheers to that.
Closet.
All right. So we're going to get things started. We're going to give each presenter 5 minutes to teach us how to make a drink. The ingredients are online. We're going to go alphabetical because that's easy. So Michael Berman, why don't you introduce for us? And we're going to spotlight you, my friends, and hand it over to you, our first teacher tonight.
All right. Thank you, Rabbi Chag Purim Sameach, everybody. So I am making something that I have called Esther's Courage. So let's hope that we can all get a little Esther's Courage to make it through the next several months until we're all vaccinated. And here we go. So this drink is has gin as the base, cherry liqueur,
we're on mute, yeah.
Lime, and mint leaves, which are already off of the sprig, so you can't see them very well. I picked the mint and the cherry and the lime because I talked to a Persian friend of mine and found out those are all Persian flavors. So what I'm going to do is first muddle the mint leaves with this muddler. If you don't have a muddler, you can use the back of an ice cream scoop. You can even use a hammer if you want to. So you put them in your mixing glass. You kind of just push it around for about 10 or 15 seconds so that it releases some of the juice. And I used about three or four mint sprigs. And this is for a double version because Terry and I will both be enjoying this cocktail tonight. All right, the mint is up. More time to add the alcohol. So I'm going to put some ice in there because we're going to end up shaking this. So this is a cocktail shaker. To make one of these, you would use 1.5 ounces of gin. I'll use 3 ounces again because I'm making two. I'm using a jigger here, but you can use any kind of measure. You can measure in cups, you can use tablespoons. You could also probably just eyeball it a little bit. All right, 1.5 ounces of gin. Next is the cherry liqueur, and I'd use 3/4 ounce of cherry liqueur, so I'll double that for this one.
Gin, cherry liqueur.
Next comes lime. I don't really measure the lime. I just squeeze half of the lime for each drink. So I'll squeeze a full lime for this, but I think it's about 3/4 ounce also. So your total recipe for this is really, it's 2 parts gin, 1 part lime juice, 1 part cherry liqueur, and then the mint leaves. Get the second half of the lime squeezed here. This is way harder than on the cooking shows where there's someone to do all the grunt work for you in the background. All right, next thing we're going to do is shake it up. Shake it for about 10 or 15 seconds. I'm going to serve this drink up into chilled martini glasses. So I'm just pouring the ice out of the martini glasses. Take the shaker, use a strainer. This is the kind that I've been using. And I'll try to pour and not spill on the laptop while I do it. There's one. All And there is two. That one is for my lovely wife. This one's for me. And L'chaim.
L'chaim, amazing. L'chaim. Any questions? Did anyone miss anything? Anyone have some thoughts or variations?
Remind us of the name of that one, Michael.
Esther's Courage.
That was impressive. Feel free. If anyone, if Michael's still here. We still got a couple more minutes with him. Anyone that have questions, comments, adaptations?
Michael, you did a wonderful job. I don't know if you could see me racing around, but it's hard to keep up.
I definitely encourage you all to add chats and comments. Have some fun. Feel free to be ridiculous. And Ruth's right. The bottle of bourbon is on my desk, not my closet. I was trying to be presentable and professional, considering the members of the board are here tonight. But, you know, whatever.
So, Michael, why did you name this Esther's Courage?
Well, I thought that a little pun on liquid courage. And what's more important in Purim than the courage Esther had to do what she did, you know? And I thought we could also all use a little courage right now. It's been a tough year. It's interesting to reflect because Purim was the first holiday that was affected by COVID last year. So we've come around and probably none of us thought we were going to be here, but here we are still. And, you know, maybe next Purim we'll be able to get together and celebrate together and really tie one on.
And cheers to that. Thank you to Michael. Let's give a bit of L'chaim and a mazal tov to Michael. Thank you so much.
L'chaim.
L'chaim. We turn L'chaim. Over to L'chaim. Dan Charlton as our next mixology expert for tonight. Dan, take it away.
Hey, how's everyone doing? Can you hear me?
Yeah, you're great.
Perfect. Great. Okay, so ingredients. You absolutely need a big squeezer like this. No, you don't. I'll show you different ways of squeezing citrus. I have a big lemon, a big lime, a variety of cucumbers, English and non-English. I don't know where this one's from. I have Thai basil, other basil. I don't know where this one's from. Anyway, lots of different ingredients, lots of different ways to make this drink. It's not too particular. But let's start with making a couple cuts of cucumber. Just I'm gonna make a couple slices, like two slices, and then I'm gonna cut them into pieces about that big. So just eight little pieces like that. Set that aside. And then I'm going to try, I have Thai basil, so I'm going to use that. But if you have regular basil, that's fine. I'm just going to take two leaves. And I'm going to put all that in my mixing vessel. And what am I going next? Sugar cubes. Let me know if I'm going too fast. So I've got sugar cubes. You could also use simple syrup if you have that. What I've learned in making drinks is add a little bit of sugar at a time and don't put too much because it's hard to, if you go too sweet, it can be really gross, but you can always add a little more sugar later. Oh, someone says they spy a dreidel cup. Oh yes, for simple syrup. So if you do want to make simple syrup, a really quick way is you just take a microwavable mug and put a spoonful of sugar and a spoonful of water, microwave it for about 10 seconds, and there you go. I'm gonna put two sugar cubes in, and now I'm gonna try to crush those with my muddler. I don't want to muddle it too much because if I squish the cucumber too much, it'll turn into this kind of pulp. It'll get it's kind of hard to drink. Just a little bit of muddling. And then I'm going to add some ice. Put that set aside there. Okay, now the fun stuff. My favorite part is citrus. So I'm going to slice my lemon. And so I'm going to use my citrus press, but if you don't, let me just get a fork real quick. I'm back. So if you don't have a citrus press and you want to juice a lemon and you don't have one of those hand squeezers, you don't have any special tools, it's actually really easy. I'll do it just so you can see in one of these glasses. You just take a fork and you kind of push it in a couple times and then squeeze, hold it with one hand and rotate the fork with the other. This is a trick, you can do this anywhere, no special tools. And it might not get as much juice as some of the special fancy tools, but it's pretty good. So there's half lemon. Now I'm gonna do half a lime. I'll do the same trick. Lime's gonna be a little trickier. Sometimes you have to little bit messy. The big bowl is probably better. Okay, so I'm gonna take that juice, pour it in. And now vodka, I've got the cheap stuff, which is just fine. I'm gonna do about 2 ounces. Oh, wait, excuse me, 3 ounces. Okay, and now I'm gonna shake it. Okay, so one thing about this drink is, again, there's the cucumber can kind of turn into a pulp. So you might wanna strain it. So there you have it, just use lemonade. Mine, because I didn't strain it, there's little seeds in there. Now this is a pretty, it can be a pretty strong drink. So if you want to, you could add some soda water, like Sprite, or I have club soda. I'm just gonna add a little bit to mine.
Doesn't make the drink any weaker.
Get a taste. Refreshing. And if you wanted to make a kid's version, just skip the vodka and put a bunch of Sprite in it. It'll be sweet and they'll love it.
I love that Vashti comes after Esther in this particular.
Absolutely. Dan, that is amazing. Can we get a big cheers and applause and a gratitude to Dan? That is impressive.
Woo! That looks good.
Oh, wait, Hazel's got a kid drink? That's awesome. Oh my God, this is amazing. Let's keep on rolling. Dad, that was incredible. That is more ingredients than I have in my glass, but that is wonderful. Let's turn over to Shelly Cohn for drink number 3. Come on, Shelly.
I'm here.
Let's okay. Do it.
So, this is called a Jaffa Gate, and it is a drink that I've reverse engineered that I had probably just exactly a year ago tonight at a cocktail bar in Jerusalem when we were all on the temple trip last year in the before times. And since we're actually taking a few days at the coast, we just got here this afternoon. So I have pre-mixed my drinks. And this was a wonderful trick that I learned when we were able to get cocktails to go. So think ahead for when you can actually have people in your house again. You can do all this prep work ahead of time, and then it's really quick to get the cocktails going. So that's kind of fun. So what is in this drink is mint. Mint seems to be a thing tonight. So I have some mint leaves. For a single drink would be about 3 mint leaves, but I'm making 2 of them tonight because somebody else here will partake. And then for one drink, it's 1.5 ounces of tequila, 1/2 ounce of gin, 1/2 to 3/4 of an ounce of lime juice, and half an ounce of za'atar simple syrup. That sounds complicated. It's not. I use double strength simple syrup, so one cup of water to two cups of sugar, because it keeps better in the fridge. And then periodically, I pour some of that off, warm it up, throw in some za'atar till it looks kind of muddy and weird. And that's what we've got. So that's what's in here. Actually, I'm going to muddle this mint first. Just kind of squeeze a little bit to release the essential oils, but not bruise it too badly. Then I'm going to take the tequila gin simple syrup and lime juice, toss it all in there. You will notice, the za'atar has stuck to the bottom. You will notice that I did not put ice in here, and that's because the next ingredient is egg white. And another life hack, you can get pasteurized egg white in the grocery store, so you don't have to figure out what to do with all those egg yolks. And what I'm going to do first is a dry shake without ice. So here's a couple of egg whites worth. I'm going to do a dry shake because then you get a whole lot of froth on that egg yolk, which is what you're going, or egg white, which is what you're going for. So here is this lovely shaker that I got for my birthday from my daughter and her partner. I love it. It's wonderful. Anyway, here we go. So dry shake for a few seconds. And then pop this off. Now we put the ice in. And we're going to shake it again. Get it nice and cold. Break the seal on that shaker. There we go. Take this fabulous little strainer. And these are not the best glasses, but it's what we have here. And there we go. We're back in Jerusalem, folks. L'chaim.
L'chaim!
Woo! That is incredible.
Yay!
L'chaim!
That is gorgeous. Oh,
like a my God.
Beautiful, Shelly.
Beautiful drink. Jeez.
I know what next to Jerusalem means.
And to echo something that my in-law said, we get our za'atar at Market Spice in Pike Place. It is really high quality there. We use it on a lot of dishes. And they will do drop-offs, counterless pickups. So if you're looking for za'atar in the city, Market Spice is a place to go. Shelly, that is quite the drink. Oof.
Shelly, how many egg whites did you put in
there? One egg white per drink. So I use about a tablespoon of the liquid stuff. It says to use an ounce of the liquid stuff. It says to use an ounce and a half, but an ounce is plenty. And this za'atar happens to be from Jerusalem, but not everybody can get that. So
that's hard to get. I'm looking at our time. The recipe, yeah, Amy, we'll make sure to post the recipes. If not, we'll message the people. Amy, we'll get you the recipe. We have one more drink to go. This is number four, Jeremiah. Whenever you're ready, friends.
He's switching to our iPad. So
Jeremiah switching to the iPad, and this is a mocktail. So we want to make sure we have opportunities for everybody of all ages, and those who choose to drink and those who not, or those who can drink and those who aren't able to. So tonight we'll be the Iskers, or at least Jeremiah will be presenting a mocktail for us. Quite an impressive one as well. And as Dan mentioned, there are alternatives, ways to turn a cocktail into a mocktail. So you don't have to feel like you're being let out. All right, Leslie, what is his
IPA?
Oh, there he is. Ooh, fancy setup.
I have switched screens. This is live TV.
Which kid is holding
Jeremiah,
the camera?
You might know me from the Ministry of Silly Walks.
I just realized
I'm here to make a mocktail. Plot. This one is called the Purim.
Oh, wait, we muted you. Wait, hold on a second, Jeremiah.
Specific mocktail following a specific ingredient list. So I'm going to teach you how
Jeremiah, can you hear us?
You're muted again. No.
Oh, no.
Hey, Leslie, go tell him he's muted.
Please.
Y'all good. Y'all good.
Okay. First ingredient is some pink grapefruit soda. No?
What is wrong?
Uh-oh. Are you, is your hand covering up the...
Something. She, like, touched
something.
I didn't.
Yes.
Are we on mute?
Oh, you're good.
We okay.
are. Thank you.
Okay. Purim Carnival. Here's some grapefruit soda. The thing about making a mocktail is the ingredients do not have to be precisely measured because they're not like super powerful, like distilled spirits. So you can kind of play with it how you like. So I'm gonna pour about a third of a glass of this delicious Fever Tree pink grapefruit soda, which I highly recommend. Then I'm going to top that off with some Topo Chico, which is mineral water imported from Mexico. And why would anyone import mineral water from Mexico? Well, Topo Chico has one particularly special quality, and that is the carbonation. The bubbles in Topo Chico are very big and aggressive, and it just makes your mocktail really fun to drink because it's super alive in your mouth, and that's what you want. Because when you're building a mocktail, you want to layer on flavors and fun. I'm going to squeeze a little lemon in. You want all of your ingredients to be cold because when you're dealing with carbonation, if your ingredients are warm, all of your bubbles will disappear quickly. So if you have all cold ingredients, then your carbonation will last longer. So now we have layered on the citrus. This is a little herbal simple syrup that Leslie made. It's just going to add a little bit of sweetness and a little herbal flavor that's going to make it just a little more in depth. You know, this is not just like a Shirley Temple here. We're making something that is a little more exciting to drink. I'm taking some orange bitters. These bitters, just a couple of splashes. These bitters are just going to add another layer of flavor to it. There's actually a great version of this that doesn't use any grapefruit soda. If you just use your mineral water and bitters and some of the herbal simple syrup, it's almost like an Amaro spritzer without the alcohol. So now all the ingredients are in here. I'm just going to finish with a little garnish. You can use anything you want. In this case, I'm actually using one of these like gross maraschino cherries because they've got this like really nice kind of cherry syrup sweetness to them, which actually kind of just brings out the fun here. I'm just going to dip the spoon in and just put the ingredients together. You don't want to stir it because stirring it again will make you lose all of your carbonation. And also it's okay if there's some layers of flavor in there, like the flavor will change a little bit as you drink it. And that is the Purim Carnival. Mmm. Chag Sameach.
Woo! That was impressive.
I am.
Okay, if I was going to do a make a drink, I just have ice and alcohol. These drinks are fancy. I am impressed.
I'm like,
look at Jesse.
Jesse's
laughing.
Wow. These are, thank you. Can we just have a couple minutes before we open up some time to chat and relax and to prepare for an awesome spiel tonight. Can we all lift our glasses in gratitude to Michael, Shelley, Jeremiah, and Dan? Can we all give a big mazel tov and kol hakavod on the count of three to our amazing drink experts? Oh, one, a two, a three, mazel tov! Thank you.
That sword on your back.
And we have just a minute. If you made a special drink you want to share tonight, not the whole recipe, but something special you made, feel free to put it in the chat or let us know. We'd love to see if you're doing something special. Cocktail or mocktail. There's some, as Jeremiah just showed, there's some pretty impressive ingredients out there. So anyone has something special they prepared tonight, feel free to share it.
And first, I just want to say, does anyone have any follow-up questions for Michael, or Dan, or Shelley?
Yeah.
And just take yourself off a mute if that's the case.
A question about the Vashti drink. Does he prefer a regular cucumber or English cucumber? I see he had both there.
So I actually haven't tried it with the English cucumber yet. That's what I'm going to do after I've had this drink.
I also have a question about the Vashti drink. Does she refuse to be drank if you don't add the cucumber?
Rob. No. It just like doesn't go all the way down. It comes up quickly. I don't know. Any other questions for our incredible, like, really, you all, that was awesome. And it's like, we should have a Tempo Pefam cooking show is what I think. Any other questions for our mixologists?
Okay. I was just curious how many times they had to practice making the drinks and drinking them this week to make to perfect.
Good question.
I had a little practice.
Who else?
I gotta make it good.
Exactly. I chose the ingredients without knowing what I was going to make, so I had to kind of do it backwards. So there were a couple iterations. The first one was pretty awful because I muddled a whole bunch of basil leaves and the green, and the drink turned bright green, like awful green.
Well, I definitely had a whole lot of practice during dryuary making mocktails, so. That's my game. So I already knew what I was doing tonight.
Yeah. And I've pretty much been practicing since, I don't know, March.
Yeah. As someone who's received your cocktails on the go, I have to say you've perfected it, you know.
Well, it's fun. Part of it was I had to start reverse engineering this drink as soon as we got back because it was really swell. So,
how do we sign up for cocktails on the go? Yeah, sign me up.
So bring me some 4-ounce mason jars and I can arrange to return them with something
in Julie, them. I think you need a second legal driver in your household.
Is this a new member benefit that
I don't think you drink it while you're driving.
No.
So we thought that it might be nice before we begin the formal festivities. We know that we don't have many opportunities. I really, really hope next year Purim is in person. And as someone said, we're gonna totally do it right. But while we still have a few minutes, I'm gonna invite you to take yourselves off mute. And we're gonna just try to spend some time just schmoozing. We know it's difficult on mute, but and then in a few minutes we'll make the bridge from this moment to our wonderful Purim spiel for the evening. So maybe maybe if you want to take yourselves off mute and say hello.
Say what?
Hello.
Hi.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi. Hello. Love the pink hat.
Hello.
Hello.
Okay, Miss Harrison is always my favorite.
Hello.
Me. Hi, everyone.
Hello.
Myron, I've been building again. I've been woodworking in my front porch. I'll move my camera.
Are we on there?
Sure, I'm sharing with everybody. Nothing else but build.
San Francisco.
A long front porch.
Guys, you want to be on here?
Oh, yeah, very nice.
Hi, everyone.
Friend.
She's a movie
star. Who's a puppy friend?
Hi, Wendy. You look special. Anything really small.
I can invite everyone to mute, except for maybe I want to say a total thank you to Rabbi Jason for emceeing. Sorry, Rabbi Jason, to be unfair to you about where your bourbon actually is stashed.
Whatever.
Hawk some
alcohol. You have a baby in sleep regression. I need the alcohol. It's all good.
I want to thank you all for being here. Totally a huge thank you to our mixologists, and I'll just say them once again, Michael and Dan and Shelley and Jeremiah. And what we're going to do, I'm thinking actually first maybe Rabbi Dana, maybe we'll sing a traditional song and then we'll go to what is needed. So I'll just say a few words and then I'll hand it over to you because we just wanna say thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you all for being here. A few days ago at the drive-thru, someone asked me if I was queen for the day. And I said, excuse me, I am queen for life. Mm-hmm. And so that was appreciated. That was appreciated. But we are about to engage in a very special telling of the true queens of our tradition, Vashti and Esther. But we're going to do it in kind of a bizarre way because it's kind of a bizarre year. I don't know if you've noticed, but this isn't how Jews have always celebrated Purim. And so, but this of course is our holiday to declare who we are, to experience joy in community, and to recognize that we are able to overcome whatever is difficult and negative in our lives, and celebrate and be joyous and silly together. And so before we transfer to the something completely different, I'm gonna invite Rabbi Dana to lead us in a classic song for Purim. So Rabbi Dana.
Wonderful, thank you so much, Rabbi Ruth. I'm sharing the lyrics with you all now. Can you see them? Yeah, so let's sing some Chag Purim together. And bonus points, if you have anything that you can use as a grogger, you can use a box of pop, you can do anything, literally anything. The sounds of iced tea being stirred. So join with me. Chag Purim, Chag Purim, Chag Gadol HaYehudim, Masechot Rashanim, Shirim Rikudim. Havana Risha, rush, rush, rush. Havana Risha, rush, rush, rush. Havana Risha, rush, rush, rush. Haglan Rashanim, Chag Purim, Chag Purim. Ze el ze sholchim manot, machmadim, matkatim, tunifim miganot. Havana Risha, rush, rush, rush. Havana Risha, rush, rush, rush. Havana Risha, rush, rush, rush. Havara Rashanim. One more time. Hagborim, Hagborim, Hagadola Yehudim, Hashechot Rashanim, Veres Rikudim. Havara Risha, Rash, Rash, Rash. Havara Risha, Rash, Rash, Rash. Havara Risha, Rash, Rash, Rash. Hagla Rashanim. And so it, oh yes, so many, no, yes, bring your eyes out. So it is, let me stop sharing. It is my distinct honor to present to you tonight a work of a labor of love from many of the individuals you see here on your screen, actually. And so kol hakavod, and thank you to so many of you. Yes, I love Debbie and Liz. I love these little clappers. Beautiful. I want to encourage you, if you know, when you hear the name Haman in our retelling, boo, go for it. Take yourself off a mute and boo. It's fine. Oh. Okay, let's try this. Let's say it. Say it. You're getting the hang. We'll practice throughout the night. Oh, I like the chat version. That's very funny.
You're going to hear us too.
So I will warn us all before we start. This is a PG-13 spiel. 13 is at your discretion. That's what I'm going to put out there. All right, families and parents, whatever you believe is appropriate for your kiddos, I understand. But we're calling it PG-13 because there's a little raucousy romp in it. So without further ado, is there anything else, team, that I should say? Yes, Rabbi Ruth? Rabbi Ruth is gesticulating. Yes, one more thing.
One further ado, because I'm just afraid, I want to make sure with everyone who is here, let us say a huge Todah Rabbah to whatever you are, the firefighter supreme, to Rabbi Dana, who, and to her wife Gina, both of whom have helped to make this happen and who have herded the cats that are the players in this special Purim spiel. I'm afraid that not everyone will be here at the end, and we just want to say todah rabah for that. And so now, Rabbi Dana, I'm sorry, I totally interrupted you.
No, it's beautiful. Thank you so much. And I'm gonna give a big shout out to the people behind the camera and the behind the computer, so to speak, Cole Sims and Davita Sims, who have been making sure that we are able to share this tonight with all of you. Really just a beautiful experience of our community. I highly encourage you to stay till the end, because you're gonna see ridiculous things that you never thought you'd see from your clergy staff, from your Temple Beth Am staff. So you better stay till the end. Otherwise, looking at you. Here we go. Without further ado, Monty Python's Flying Purim. And now, Monty Python's Flying Purim.
It's...
Temple Beth Am's Flying Purim.
Good evening. I am Hugh Briss. I have with me tonight Bible scholar Mistress Elizabeth Am.
Miss, if you please.
You have a new theory about Megillat Esther, the Book of Esther?
Can I just say here, Mr. Briss, for one moment, that I have a new theory about Megillat Esther.
Exactly. What is it?
Where?
No, your new theory.
Oh, what is my theory? What is my theory? Well, my theory is that it is. Yes, you may well ask me what it is that is my theory.
I am asking.
Oh, good for you. My word, yes. Well, Mr. Briss, what it is that is this theory of mine, well, this is what it is, my theory that I have, which is to say that is mine. Mine. It is mine.
Yes, I know it is yours. What is it?
Where? Oh, my theory. What is my theory? That is, yes, my... A moment. My theory that belongs to me is as follows. Is as follows. This is how it goes. The next thing that I'm going to say is my theory. Ready?
Yes. Yes, please.
My theory. By Beth Am, brackets, miss, brackets. This theory goes as follows and begins now. Begins now. In the beginning of Megillat Esther, the Jews are having an okay time. Mm-hmm. Yes. Then they are on the verge of death. Mm-hmm. Then. Then they're okay again at the end. That is my theory. It is mine. It belongs to me and I own it. What it is too.
That's it.
Spot on, Mr. Briss. Spot on.
Well, this theory of yours seems to have hit the nail on the head.
And it's mine.
Yes. Thank you for coming along to the studio.
My pleasure, Mr.
Next Briss. Week, the triangular nature. Yes. Thank you.
It's
thank
been
you.
A lot of fun.
Yes. Thank you. Thank you very
saying
much.
Saying what my theory is.
Yes. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah.
And so, whose it is.
Yes. Thank you. That's all. Thank you. The triangular nature of Haman's ears.
I have another theory.
Yes.
Called my second theory, or my theory number two.
Thank you. Haman's ears next week. Very
this
good.
Second theory, which was the one that I had said
Which I could respond to.
Which I could expound without doubt. The second theory, which with the one which I have said, forms the brace of theories, which I own and which belongs to me, goes like this.
Baruch ata Adonai Rofei Kol Basor Umavli La'asot. Oh, excuse me, my apologies. Good morning, Mr. Triff. I'm sorry to have kept you waiting, but I'm afraid my prayers have become rather silly recently, and I'm sorry it's taken me quite longer to finish them up. Now then, what was it again?
Well, I have a silly prayer, and I'd really like to get your rabbinic advice on how to develop it.
I see. May I hear your prayer?
Oh, yes, yes, that'd be perfect. Okay. Oh, say, who, yes, say, I'll call Yisrael.
That's it, is it?
Yeah, that's it.
Well, it's not particularly silly. I mean, there is some volume modulation, and you did move your body slightly to one direction, and then slightly to the other direction, but frankly, that doesn't seem to be terribly silly at all, does it?
But I think if, you know, with your advice, I think I could get it to be quite silly.
Mr. Treif, the very real problem here is one of resources. I'm afraid that the Ministry of Silly Prayer is no longer getting the kind of support that it needs from the Union of Reform Judaism. You see, there's Torah and Talmud and Midrash, life cycle events, everlasting light bulbs. They're all supposed to get the same attention, but last year the URJ spent less on the development of silly prayers than they did on developing manischewitz that doesn't immediately make you sick. Now, the conservative movement, they've incorporated costume changes. That's progress. And the Chassids are supposedly including a confetti cannon. Look at us. We're merely stuck with the basic level of silliness. But to you and I, speaking of which, might we toast our meeting together, one another with a glass of water, with the appropriate blessing?
That sounds great.
Shall we?
Yes, please.
I'm Mr. Treif, not going to mince words with you. You seem quite interested in silly prayers, aren't you? And I'm going to offer you a research fellowship for the revival of silly prayers. Shall we celebrate this moment with Shehachianu together? Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu, Melech
haolam, v'hegiyanu. Right, cut to me. As board member overseeing the Purim Spiel division, I object, in the strongest possible terms, to the shtick about silly prayer, and I'm warning you all that any recurrence of this schlocky meshuggas will be dealt with most severely. All right, now, on the command cut, the camera will cut to camera Shnayim. All right. Director, cut.
Good morning.
Good morning, ma'am. Thank you for calling the National Hamantaschen Emporium.
Ah, thank you, my good woman.
What can I do for you, ma'am?
Well, I was just sitting here reading Torah, and all of a sudden I came over all peckish.
Peckish, ma'am?
Esurient.
Eh?
I was all hungry like.
Ah, hungry.
In a nutshell. And I thought to myself, a sugary carb will do the trick. So I curtailed my Torah activities, sallied forth, and contacted your place of purveyance to negotiate the vending of some sugary comestibles.
Come again?
I want to buy some pastry.
Oh, I thought you were complaining about the cats.
Oh, heaven forbid. I am one who delights in all manifestations of the feline muse.
Sorry?
I like a nice furry critter.
Oh, so the kitties don't bother you.
Most certainly. Now then, some pastry, please, my good woman.
Certainly, ma'am. What would you like?
How about a cheese Danish?
I'm afraid we're fresh out of cheese Danish, ma'am.
Oh, never mind. How are you on babka?
Oh, I'm afraid we never had that at the end of the week. Ma'am, we get it fresh on Monday.
Oh, tish tish, no matter. Well, madame, 4 slices of mandelbrot, if you please.
Ah, it's been on back order, ma'am, for 2 weeks. Was expecting it this morning.
It's not my lucky day, is it? Apple cake?
Sorry, ma'am.
Strudel.
Normally, ma'am, yes. Today, the van broke down.
Goribi.
Sorry?
Honey cake?
No.
Any tegach, perchance?
No.
Carrot cake?
No.
Moroccan cigars?
Nah.
Rugala?
No.
Sponge cake?
No.
Macaroons?
No.
Crimsel?
No.
Cheesecake.
We have cheesecake, ma'am. Yes.
We do. Excellent.
Yes, it's a bit old.
Well, I like it old.
Well, it's very old, actually, ma'am.
No matter. Fetch hither the cake au fromage. Mwah.
I think it's a bit older than you'll like, ma'am.
I don't care how fripping old it is. Hand it over with all speed.
Oh.
What now?
The cat's eaten it.
Has she?
Yes. Quite a catastrophe, Mom.
You do have some pastry, don't you?
Of course, Mom. It's a Hamantaschen shop, Mom. We've got...
No, no, don't tell me. I'm keen to guess.
Fair enough.
Hamantaschen.
Yes!
Apricot Hamantaschen?
Not as such.
Oh, plum Hamantaschen?
No.
Peach?
No.
Poppy seed?
It's our number one bestseller, Mom.
All right, okay. Have you got any? She asked, expecting the answer to be no.
I have a look, Mom. No.
It's not much of a pastry shop, is it?
Finest in district, Mom.
Explain the logic underlying that conclusion, please.
Well, it's so clean, Mom.
It's certainly uncontaminated by pastry.
You haven't asked me about prune, Mom.
Would it be worth it?
Could be.
Have you? Can you please quiet down those cats?
Hold your mom.
Have you got any prune Hamantaschen?
No.
Figures. Predictable, really, I suppose. It was an act of purest optimism to have posed the question in the first place. Tell me.
Yes, ma'am.
Have you, in fact, got any pastry at all?
Yes, ma'am.
Really?
No.
Not really.
No, ma'am, not a scrap. I was deliberately wasting your time, ma'am.
Well, I'm sorry, but I'm going to have to drown you out with groggers.
Right there, Mom.
What a waste of human life.
No.
No. No.
No.
No. No. No. No. No. No.
Where
no,
are no, you going? No. Where are you going? You cannot pass here. We are the board members who say no.
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 No, 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 no,
you cannot pass here without making a sacrifice.
No, no,
what
no,
do you have to sacrifice?
No, no, no,
no,
no, no. Bread? Pastry? Bread?
Pastry!
Tell them to unmute their audio.
How about triangular pastry?
Oh, yes. No one. Yes. Oh, no.
No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No.
No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No.
No. No. No.
No. No. No. No. No.
No. No. No. No.
Mordecai!
King Ahasuerus, please!
May
please
I?
Yes.
Thank you, my good man. Yes, thank you.
It's a pleasure.
King. Lovely festival. Have you seen that Esther out there?
Yes, of course.
Esther, but she's your cousin, eh?
Well, you see, our family tree is actually quite vague, sir. She's my twice with my yes, she's my she's my cousin. Let's
your go. Cousin.
Yes,
your
yes,
cousin.
My cousin. Yes, yes.
Is she a goer? Hey? Does she go? Nudge, nudge. Wink, wink. Say no more.
I suppose she goes, sir. Yes.
I bet she does. I bet she does. She's a goer. Know what I mean? Know what I mean? Nudge, nudge. Wink, wink.
Yes, yes, I suppose she does. But I don't understand, sir.
Ah! Understand, understand, understand. That's good. Very good. A nod as good as a wink to a blind bat. Nudge, nudge, wink, wink. Eh?
I'm sorry, King. Are you trying to buy something?
Buying something. Buying something. Oh, you're wicked, eh? Wicked, wicked. Know what I mean? Know what I mean? Nudge, nudge, wink, wink. Say no more.
I don't quite understand, sir.
You asked her. She a dancer, eh? She like to dance?
Yes, I suppose she does.
I bet she does. I bet she does.
Yes, yes, I suppose she likes the polka.
Polka, eh?
Yes, yes, she likes polka.
She likes dancing, likes polkas, a little pop and lock, a little jitterbug. Say no more. Knew she would. She'd like to dance. She's been around, eh? I bet she's been around. She been around, know what I mean? Nudge, nudge, wink, wink.
Yes, she's traveled, sir, but she is from Shushan.
Shushan! Say no more! Shushan, know what I mean? Say no more! Your cousin interested in, photographs? Photos? Little snaps, nudge, nudge, wink, wink. He asked Morty knowingly.
Photography.
Yes, could be photography. Snap, snap, wink, wink, nudge, nudge, smile, smile, say cheese, say no more, say no more.
Festival snaps. Could be taken at a festival.
Ooh, dancing costumes. Maybe a diadem, know what I mean? Know what I mean? Nudge, nudge, wink, wink.
No, so we don't have a camera, so I don't know what we'd.
Still, eh? Whoa! Whoa! Right, eh? Whoa!
I'm sorry, sir. Are you trying to insinuate something?
Oh! Oh! No! 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 Yes.
Well,
I mean, you're a man of the world, aren't you?
I suppose so, yes.
You know a thing or two? You've been around?
I've traveled, yes.
I mean, you have, you've slept with a lady?
Yes.
What's it like?
Hi, Bubby. Hi, Zadie. How are you? It's been so long. I miss you.
Did you get your vaccine yet?
No, not yet. What about you?
Are you wearing a mask?
Always. And how are things with you?
Are you eating?
Yes.
Did the snow melt?
Yep.
Are you seeing anyone?
Bobby.
Well, you know, we just wanted to know what's going on with you.
I guess I just wasn't expecting some kind of Bubby Inquisition.
Nobody expects the Bubby Inquisition. Our chief weapon is tradition, and guilt, and tradition. Our two weapons are guilt and comfort food. Our three weapons are guilt, tradition, and comfort food, and invasive personal questions. Amongst our weaponry are such elements as guilt, tradition. Can we try this again?
Sure. I didn't expect a kind of Bubby Inquisition.
Nobody expects the Bubby Inquisition. Amongst our weaponry are such diverse elements as guilt, tradition, comfort food, and invasive personal questions. And nitrate uniforms. Oh, damn. Zadie, I can't say it. You'll have to say it.
What?
You'll have to say the bit about our chief weapons are...
I couldn't do that.
Well, I didn't expect a kind of Bubby Inquisition.
Nobody,
Expects?
Nobody expects, the Bubby,
Inquisition!
I know. Nobody expects the Bubby Inquisition. In fact, those who do expect...
Our chief weapons are...
Tradition and...
Stop there. Ugh. Our chief weapon is tradition, blah, 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 blah. Zadie, read the charges.
You are hereby charged that you did on diverse dates commit the sin of never calling. You never call. Why don't you ever call your Bubby and Zadie?
That's enough. Now, how do you plead?
I'm innocent. Millennials are terrified of using the phone. It's not my fault.
Well, we'll soon change your mind about that.
Guilt, tradition, and comfort. Now, Zadie, the personal questions.
Right. When are you moving back home?
Are you exercising?
And when are you getting married?
How long will it take you to make us some great-grandchildren?
Did you ever call that nice young person from our temple the doctor? You haven't been ordering out too much, have you?
Are you still a vegetarian? Never mind. I'll send you some nice muscle soup.
And have you met with the rabbi yet?
Such a nice girl.
Morning. What have you got, Ben?
Well, there's egg and lox, egg onion and lox, egg and lox, egg chicken sausage and lox, egg onion chicken sausage and lox, chicken sausage and lox, lox egg lox lox chicken sausage and lox, lox 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 egg and lox, lox 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 baked beans lox 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 and lox, or white fish thermidor au crevet with a mornay sauce garnished with truffle pate, brandy, and with a fried egg on top and lox.
Have you got anything without lox in it?
Well, there's lox eggs, chicken sausage and lox. That's not got much lox in it.
I don't want any lox.
Why can't you have eggs, turkey bacon, lox, and chicken sausage?
That's got lox in it.
Not as much as lox, egg, chicken, sausage, and lox.
Look, could I have egg lox and chicken and sausage without the lox? What do you mean? I don't like lox.
Shut up. You can't have egg, turkey, bacon, lox, and chicken sausage without the lox.
Why not?
It wouldn't be egg, turkey, bacon, lox, and chicken sausage, would it?
I don't like lox.
Don't make a fuss, dear. I'll have your lox. I love it. I'm having lox. Baked beans, lox.
Baked beans are off.
Well, can I have lox instead?
You mean lox?
Lux.
Yes. Shut up.
Cornidre Vesare Vicharame Vichoname Vichinuye Vichinuse Vese Usheru.
Dear sir, madam, or person in charge of this spiel, I wish to complain in the strongest possible terms about the sketch that you have just broadcast about self-flagellation on Yom Kippur. Many of my best friends self-flagellate, and only a few of them have ever knocked themselves out during cold nidre. Yours faithfully, Rabbi Yitzhak Stein Rabinowitz, on behalf of the Ministry of Depressing Prayers. P.S. I've never accidentally drank beer during Passover. P.P.S. I've never slapped anyone with a gefilte fish either.
One day, Haman, all this will be your kingdom, and all that you can see stretched out over the hills and valleys of this land.
But, Your Highness, I really don't care about the land.
Now listen, Haman, I built this kingdom up from nothing. When I started here, all this was a swamp, and then I built my castle, and it sank into the swamp. So I built a second castle, and that one sank into the swamp. Then I built a third one, but it burned down. It fell over, and then it sank into the swamp. But the fourth one, it stayed up. And that is what I'm going to give to you, Haman, the strongest castle in the land.
But I don't want any of that. I'd rather...
Rather what?
I'd rather just... sing!
Stop that. You're not going to go into song while I'm here.
But I don't want the kingdom.
Well, then what the hell do you want out of life?
I've always had a desire to dedicate my life to a certain special something.
Cut that out.
Thank you.
am Haman, and I rule Cain. And this stuff the Jews didn't bow to today. I help the king with everything. I try to amass more power. I like to attend festivals and dance around for hours.
Helps the king with everything. He tries to amass more power. He likes to attend festivals and dance around for hours.
I am Haman, I am Haman. And this that the Jews didn't bow today. I want a horse, I want a robe, a scepter and a ring. I'd like to feel important, so I want to be the king.
He wants a horse, he wants a robe, a scepter and a ring. He'd like to feel important, so he wants to be the king. He's in the king,
this guy, this Mordechai, my authorities refuse. If I can't be a royal, I guess I'll kill the Jews.
It's this guy, Mordechai, my authorities refuse.
If he can't be a royal,
I guess I'll kill the Jews.
That's terrible. The orchestra is Jewish.
But I really love bagels. I mean, where am I going to get a good ride? Like, all of them?
I am Haman, and I'm okay.
And here I was thinking you were such a mensch.
And now the Temple Bethom players present a semaphore version of Megillat Esther.
Point out first, Haman, in all fairness, that I am not, in fact, the rescuing party. However, I have been asked to read the following statement on behalf of the crown. We, the royal sovereign, myself, do hereby convey my sincere royal thoughts and prayers to you, Haman. On this, the day of your execution.
What?
Your death will stand as a hallmark in the continuing struggle for the Jews to protect and liberate themselves from the hands of all manner of aggressors, and to your future would-be exterminators of our glorious people. I hereby decree that your name be always drowned out by all manner of horrid sounds, including, but not limited to, groggers, booing, cowbell, vuvuzelas, a tin can full of pennies, wet sneezes, dry sneezes, sad trombones, children singing, more cowbell, wet farts, dry farts, sounds dads make when they get up off the couch, and slash or air horns. Signed, on behalf of myself, the Royal Sovereign, and I'd just like to acknowledge, on a personal note, my condolences. And what must be, after all, for you, Haman, a very difficult time. Raymond, and thanks for giving us one more reason to get hammered and eat cookies.
Wait, King, before you go, could I say a few last words?
I suppose you have 1 minute.
All right. Okay. I want to express to my fellow Jews.
Just kidding, my dear. I don't give a damn. King Ahasuerus out.
You jerk! You mutton-chopped banana peel pineapple sorbet! Mother of pearls of shiitake mushrooms, jerk! How dare you? I'm certain that I am still destined for greatness. This isn't the last you'll hear from Haman!
Some things in life are bad. They can really make you mad. Other things just make you swear and curse. When you're chewing on life's gristle, don't grumble, give a whistle. And this'll help things turn out for the best. And always look on the bright side of life. Always look on the light side of life. If life seems jolly rotten, there's something you've forgotten, and that's to laugh and smile and dance and sing. When you're feeling in the dumps, don't be silly chumps, just purse your lips and whistle, that's the thing. And
always look on the bright side of life. Always look on the light side of life.
For life is quite absurd, and that's the final word.
You must always face the curtain with a bow.
Forget about your sin, give me your chin with a grin. Enjoy it, it's your last chance anyhow. So always look on the bright side of death.
Just before you draw your terminal breath.
Life's a piece of when you look at it. Life's a laugh and death's a joke, it's true. You'll see it's all a show. Keep on laughing as you go. Just remember that the last laugh is on you. And
always look on the bright side of life. Always look on the bright side of life.
Come on, guys, cheer up.
Always look on the bright side of life.
That was a teaching. That was a teaching.
That means it's getting over soon.
Always look on the bright side of life.
You know, worse things have happened, like a pandemic for a
Always
year
look
over
on
Purim.
The bright side of life.
I mean, what did we have to lose? You know, we come
Always
from nothing, we're gonna go back to nothing. What have we lost? Nothing.
Life.
Nothing becomes
Always
of nothing. You know what they say. Oh, cheer up, you old buggers. Come on. Really, though. There you are. See? The end of the spiel. Incidentally, if you would like to help support Temple Beth Am, you can just go to our website and make a donation. We will have a recording of this video so you can share just how ridiculous we are with your family and friends. Who do you think pays for all this rubbish?
Always look on the bright side of life.
Great job.